In the heartwarming tale of Ted Lasso, Ted's family embarks on a journey of more than 4,000 miles from their home to the United Kingdom, all in the name of spending precious time together. This touching episode unveils the depths of Ted's character as he faces pivotal moments both in his professional career and within the walls of his home. Upon their arrival, Ted beams with pride as he introduces his wife, Michelle, and their son to the AFC Richmond team. Together, they share the quintessential British experience of fish and chips at Ted's beloved pub. At first glance, they appear to be the picture-perfect family, but beneath the surface, cracks have formed in their marital foundation. Ted has already confided in Rebecca about their problems, and tense phone calls have punctuated their relationship in previous episodes. In a heart-wrenching scene, Ted stumbles upon Michelle in tears, a moment that serves as a poignant backdrop to his team's struggles on the field. Jamie, the team's talented yet insufferably arrogant player, continues to be a thorn in Ted's side. His selfishness knows no bounds, refusing to pass the ball and declaring himself the sole focus of the audience's attention. The tipping point arrives when Sam sustains an injury during the game, and Jamie can't be bothered to check on his teammate. Roy, fueled by anger at Jamie's self-centeredness, instigates a fight. In the midst of this chaos, Ted makes a daring decision that will change the course of the game and his life. He benches Jamie, a radical move that shakes the team's dynamics. During halftime, Ted delivers a stirring speech, urging his players to embrace change. It's not just about the game, it's a profound realization that he needs to let Michelle go. The gamble pays off as, without Jamie on the field, the team finds a new sense of unity, working together to score the winning goal, securing their first victory of the season. Even the jeers from the crowd take on a different meaning, transforming from insults to symbols of resilience. Amid the jubilant celebration, there's one person who doesn't share in the joy. Rebecca, typically the orchestrator of chaos in Ted's life, looks distinctly displeased by the team's triumph. As the cheers reverberate around them, this victory marks a turning point for Ted, both in his career and in his journey toward personal growth and self-realization. The AFC Richmond team welcomes a new addition to their ranks, the remarkable soccer talent, Dani Rojas, portrayed by Christo Fernandez. Dani's arrival is like a breath of fresh air for the team, and Ted Lasso couldn't be happier. He's been grappling with Jamie's resistance to cooperate with the team, and Dani's exceptional skills offer a glimmer of hope. However, Jamie's indifference to practice continues to vex Ted. It reaches a breaking point, triggering a rare outburst from the usually genial coach. The scene may ring familiar to some, for it cleverly parodies the infamous Allen Iverson rant. Ted's solution to Jamie's apathy is to put Dani in his place on the field. Witnessing someone else claim his spot gives Jamie pause, leading him to reassess his priorities. Ted's attempt to stoke a rivalry between the two players bears fruit, and he finds himself with two aces on the field. Amidst the Jamie drama, Dani encounters an invisible obstacle on the field, attributing it to his recent visit to the fabled treatment room. The treatment room, it seems, bears a sinister reputation as a place cursed by ghosts, a curse dating back to the War of 1814. Young men, lured into trying out for the soccer team, were deceptively enlisted for war, only to meet their demise overseas. Should Dani succumb to a phantom injury, the team's morale would undoubtedly suffer. Ted hatches a plan to rid the field of these apparitions through a ceremonial offering. Gathering all the team members in the locker room that evening, Ted instructs them to bring a significant item to burn as an offering to appease the restless spirits. In a surprising turn of events, Jamie makes an appearance, contributing an item that reminds him of his mother. Jamie's revelation in that moment is poignant. His mother always cherished his happiness and encouraged his best efforts on the team, regardless of his skill level. His father, on the contrary, was far less kind. When Jamie rose to prominence, his father began attending games, berating him as soft and weak when he faltered. Jamie's determination to be unbreakable made him forget the joy of making his mother proud. As the team and Ted take the offering to the field, a sense of unity fills the air. They gather together, singing and sharing in Dani's mezzal. For the first time all season, they become a real united team, a transformation not lost on the observant Rebecca. Amidst the flickering flames and shared stories, the ghosts of the past seem to dissipate, leaving behind a stronger, more resilient team, ready to face their challenges together. AFC Richmond ventures to Liverpool for an away game against the formidable Everton team. Little did they know, this weekend out of town coincides with a significant milestone in Rebecca's life, her first anniversary as a divorcee. To help her navigate this emotional territory, she makes a surprising decision. She asks Higgins to stay home and invites Keely along for the ride instead. Rebecca hopes this girl's weekend will provide a much-needed distraction from her troubles. The chemistry between Keely and Rebecca, which fans of their relationship adore, shines brightly in this episode. Keely's unmistakable crush on Rebecca becomes evident as she playfully jokes about wanting to have some wicked sex as she dips her toe back in the lady pool. It might not be an outright confirmation, but for many, it's a subtle acknowledgement of Keely's bisexuality. The Richmond team doesn't harbor high hopes for the Liverpool game, especially considering their long-standing streak of not winning against Everton for over 6 decades. The absence of Jamie, who has left the team, only adds to their uncertainty. The reporters briefly touch on Jamie's departure, wondering how Ted feels about it. Ted, seeking a fresh approach to motivate his team and boost their spirits, turns to Nate. He asks Nate to jot down his thoughts on the team and what he would say to inspire them. Nate, as usual, is hesitant, fearing that his words might inadvertently lead to his own dismissal. However, he musters the courage to hand his notes to Ted. In an uncharacteristic moment, Ted reacts with frustration, snapping at Nate. Nate, unaware of Ted's personal turmoil, tries to slip his pages under Ted's hotel room door, unknowingly interrupting Ted as he grapples with his divorce papers. To make matters worse, he receives a text message from Michelle's lawyer, a stark reminder of the end of his marriage. For Ted, it feels like Michelle is rushing to rewrite their family's story with a simple text message. The years that he had invested in their relationship seem to have evaporated in the blink of an eye. Agitated, he chastises Nate to return to his room and stop acting recklessly after curfew, although he does accept the pages. As expected, Ted later apologizes to Nate, and their bond remains unbroken. He confesses that he read Nate's notes and agrees with every word, acknowledging that it might not carry the same weight coming from him. He tasks Nate with delivering the pre-game pep talk. Meanwhile, Rebecca's longtime friend, Flo Sarsi Collins, unexpectedly joins them for the weekend. But despite the presence of friends and companionship, it's not a fantastic weekend for everyone. This episode peels back the layers of Ted's character, revealing a vulnerable side that hasn't been explored extensively before, adding depth and complexity to the story of Ted Lasso. In the wake of the Liverpool away game and a night of raucous celebrations, everyone finds themselves nursing hangovers and facing the repercussions of their actions. The aftermath is a tumultuous blend of confusion and confrontations. For Ted, it's a morning filled with uncertainty as he grapples with the emotions stirred by his one-night stand with Sarsi. Rebecca, on the other hand, discovers an unexpected guest in her bedroom and promptly shows the hot way to the door. Meanwhile, Nate, determined not to miss the bus, sacrifices his comfort by sleeping inside it. The weight of the previous night's events hangs heavily on Ted, whose anxiety reaches a breaking point at the karaoke bar. This night, marked by both a panic attack and his rendezvous with Sarsi, is one that marks a significant chapter in his life the night he officially became divorced. Seeking solace and guidance, he turns to his newly formed advisory group, the Diamond Dogs, comprising Nate, Coach Beard, and Higgins. Surprisingly, they prove adept at handling complex situations, providing Ted with a simple yet profound piece of advice. Cut himself some slack. Rebecca, on the other hand, has her own challenges to face. She invites Ted to accompany her to a meeting with the minority club shareholders, the Milk Sisters. However, their meeting takes an unexpected turn when Rupert, Rebecca's wealthy ex-husband, and his new fiancé, also named Rebecca, make an appearance. Rupert manipulates Rebecca into buying out the Milk Sisters' 2.9% ownership stake in the club, effectively making him a part owner once they marry. Rupert seizes every opportunity to belittle and taunt Rebecca, even stooping to thinly veiled racist remarks directed at Sam, a move that further fuels the audience's disdain for him. The evening reaches its climax with a high-stakes dart game between Ted and Rupert, a battle of wits and pride. The terms are clear. If Ted wins, Rupert must stay far away from the owner's box while Rebecca is in charge. If Rupert prevails, he gains control over the starting lineup for the final 2 games of the season. In a triumphant victory, Ted not only emerges as the winner, but also delivers a powerful speech that strikes at the heart of Rupert's arrogance. Ted reflects on a lifetime of ridicule by those who choose judgment over curiosity. He reveals that he used to play darts with his father every Sunday until his father's passing when Ted was just 16. This poignant revelation knocks the smug smirk off Rupert's face, but he still leaves the bar with Rebecca by his side. Rebecca, brimming with pride, returns to the office, where she shares the tale of her victory with Higgins. Yet, as she relishes in the triumph of her evening, Higgins arrives with some unfortunate news, setting the stage for the next chapter.